Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Crablord back again. Today, we're going to be doing another Drake vocal effect or tutorial, because it's not really an effect, but very smooth, very simple, very sweet. We're going to be basing it off the song Laugh Now, Cry Later. Now, my last Drake tutorial slash tutorials, if I did more than one, they sucked. I don't think they were good at all. Now, this one, I like. So, before we get into the video, make sure to subscribe and subscribe, notification bell as well, so you never miss a video that I post, because I realized something. My channel seems to be dying a little bit, but I can tell that you guys are always returning the same amount of people. So, I'm making these videos for you guys, not the rest of the internet that this video is promoting. And also check out my description down below. I got preset packs, which I might throw this Drake one up on there. I don't know. All my equipment, all my music, all my social media. Support link for the preset pack and a DistroKid link to get your songs on the iTunes, Apple Music, Spotify, all of them. Anyway, Drake, Laugh Now, Cry Later. Let's see the video. I would like to say this first is that I suck at, I cannot perform this song at all. Not saying I can perform other songs, but for other songs, I can at least do it somewhat. I can't flow very well with this, so just ignore anything that just sounds weird. So this beat was reproduced by Success with the 6 as the first C. I'll link in the description. Check them out.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Baby, we take a trip, now we're in your block, and it's like a ghost town. Baby, whoa, why are you staying here? Why are you touching me below?
So if you like how that sounded, this is how you get it. So like I said, it's a very simple, non-effect style vocal. And I'm gonna bring the lead down to where I'm talking on right now. So, I'm currently talking on a completely dry track right now. As you can see where my mouse thing is, these are the effects, and this is the vocal. Keep in mind that there is no bus 2. I just had that there to test. So we're gonna start off by dragging each thing over really quickly. Here we go. Pitch correction. Don't worry about it. If you need it, you need it. And if you need to find what your pitch is, that's a whole different story, because it has nothing to do with this beat. Pitch correction mono, but I can at least tell you, you want it first in the vocal chain, and you also want a little response time about 40 to 50. That's the response time where you can get like a nice singing voice and kind of mask that you're using autotune. So, I got natural minor scale A. That is what I got for this, but it doesn't matter. Just know that your response time got to be like that. Play it with just pitch correction.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
Next is a noise gate. A noise gate just cuts it, makes it sound cleaner, makes it a more professional sounding vocal. That is Dynamics noise gate mono. See, this is not really an effect, so like, it's kind of like a staple plugin you can use. All I do is I click the top, go down to tighten up. When you click tighten up, all you gotta do is make the threshold about negative 35 to negative 40. That's a good spot for me usually. All depends on the volume of your vocals anyway. So this is what it sounds like with those.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
Next, we're rocking out with a channel EQ. So this is the initial one. It's gonna clean it up. We're talking about EQ, channel EQ, stereo. Sometimes it's mono, sometimes it's stereo. Yeah, I'm retarded. When you're inside of it, simply, you can double click all these values and change them to get exactly what I have. But if not, what you want to do is take the red all the way to 200, to click the dot and drag it to where it says 18 dB down there, if you can see. Then you take this green to 400 and go negative 2. Don't change the width. Then you take the blue and take it to 5,000, raise 2. Then you cut off 15,000, negative 6. Right here. This right here is the simple staple thing that I like to do in everything. So you get the main three here. And with these three, it's what it sounds like.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
All right, now we're going compressors. We got a double compressor action here. So the first compressor, Dynamics compressor, stereo. It's in stereo this time. Use mono if you don't have stereo. Studio VCA. It's the red one, my favorite. It's very smooth. Auto gain's off. Ratio of 5.2 to 1. A little on the heavier side. Threshold of negative 35.5. The goal here was to get the little needle to bounce between 0 and negative 5. Maybe even hit the negative 7 marks or 10. Makeup of 0. I didn't want to make it up. Attack 95. The slower the attack, the smoother it's going to sound. Release is at 150. No distortion. Close it and let's propose it.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
Next compressor. We're talking about Dynamics. Compressor stereo again. And in this one, we did a classic VCA. Never used this one, so I wanted to use it. It lacks the knobs to make attack and release, so I figured it'd be easier. Auto gain off. Distortion off. Ratio of 3.3 to 1. A little lighter than the last one. Threshold of negative 28.5. Also a little lighter, and a makeup of 5. So we're bringing back volume with this compressor as opposed to the first one. And the needle also bounces between 0 and negative 5 basically here. So we put back 5. Close it. Remember, I can't exactly tell you why I do things, because that's just the way I roll.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
This is a very quick tutorial, and I like it. And next is channel EQ. Channel EQ, EQ, channel EQ stereo. It's all stereo today. That means we're just going stereo. This one's different. It's hard to pinpoint what frequencies are being boosted. So I figured maybe I'll just boost the 400 area that I took away from earlier. It's a little more of the muddy side, but it makes the vocal a lot less thin. Like, his vocal didn't have much low end, but it wasn't that thin. So I took the green to about 400 and I raised it 2.6 dB. And I made the width 0.6. Remember, click the dot and then you drag it, make it 0.6. And then the blue as well. Over for 6,500, take the blue, make it 2.5 as well. The width isn't changed, 0.4. Remember, click the dot. Close it, play it.
Yeah, next is tape delay. Bring it over. Simple tape delay. We just want a little bit of delay. Tape delay, stereo. It's all stereo. This is a nice little effect that I heard within the song, but it's also something that's hard to say because it all depends on the tempo of your song. For this time, I got delay time of a half note. That means that it's going to repeat itself every half of the note. I honestly can't tell you why it does things the way it does things. I just like to hear it and like how it sounds, how I work. Now, this is important though. Low cut 220, high cut 5300, dry 100, wet 10%. What is just how much you'll hear the delay? So 10% is not much at all. Feedback 16, that means you're gonna hear the delay one time and then that's it. But remember, the best way I can say to find what note you want in the delay is just to listen to the song and just test, guess and check each time. Just keep guessing each note until it sounds good to you. And then there, yeah, let's play it.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
Nice. Now finally for the little cherry on top, we're gonna be talking about a nice little bus one delay. Click bus one. Bus one will now appear. Mine was already there. All right, now once the bus is there, in bus one, I want you to put a space designer, reverb, space designer, stereo. The first step you want to do inside is click the top here, go to large space, plate, hot plate. Now you have the hot plate preset. Wet's negative 10, dry is 0. All this I did not change. As well as go to the top right and click output EQ. You can kind of direct what frequencies that you want to have the reverb on. I don't like it on the high end because it really amplifies the sharp sounds and makes them very loud and annoying. So I took the purple to about 6,000 hertz and that's where I cut off the high end. So you just take it about 6,000 and there we have it. Close it and then you can turn on the bus one that goes to negative 10, okay? Smooth. Now let's play it.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now.
And what I'm gonna do right now, I like how the vocal is now, but quickly, I didn't even test this. I'm gonna do my Command D trick. I'm gonna hold Option and drag it down. And what I'm gonna do is on top of all this, I'm gonna throw a sample delay. I'll turn off the tape delay. And I'll turn a sample delay on, just so I can have it spread around my ears a little more, stereo-wise. And maybe it'll give it a fuller sound to make it sound better. Make it reverb everything.
Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Whoa,
well, now that you learned that, I'm just gonna play around with it and make some freestyles up and display it in its glory.
Oh, I can't do this song. I can't do it.
1, 2, 3, I fell in a hole. Then I woke up, turned into a mole. What am I even saying? Games I'm playing. I've said that before in a different freestyle. Freestyle every day. I woke up and I'm gay. Wait, take that back, oh take it back. I meant that I'm great. My hand has a big jug right in it. I just spilled water on my dick.
How could I just do that?
I try to be funny with that water in my mouth. All that just happened is that I got it on my pants, but it made me wanna dance. I just went outside and in a trance. I was in a trance and I pulled my pants. This beat's so easy to freestyle to. It's in the right damn key, and I know I can make a tune.
I was a small little dude, I was chilling in the house. Then I came in the house and I was a mouse. Then I had a spouse, and then I had some grouse. And then I went outside and I took off my blouse. When I wear a blouse, man, I feel like a woman. And I'm really like a woman and I ain't a woman. If I was a woman, you would know right now. If I took my hair out, it would fall to the ground. And I'm gonna freestyle to the very end. And I never gave up, I have no friends.
That's about it for me, hope you guys enjoyed that video, learned something as well. And if you didn't, then I apologize. Make sure to drop a like on the video, leave a comment down below, tell me what you think. And also tell me why I'm failing. Like I said before, make sure you already subscribe, notification bell as well. Description's chock full of sweet things down below, including preset packs that probably will be released in the future. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. This has been Incredible. How to sound like Drake in the song Laugh Now Cry Later, and Logic Pro 10 uses only stock plugins that are free, which means they're free. And like always,
I love you. We out.